Hi guys, in this example I am going to explain some more examples of use callback. Okay, so for that one I have created one sample project, my app. Inside that app.js file I have removed all the by default code. Now if I try to run in localhost 3000, I can see my project is running. Now if I add some text here, okay, let's add some text here, I can see that text is coming here. Okay, now what I am going to do here, I am going to create a child component, let's say one, okay, .j child component one. Okay, now I am going to import React from React, clear, and I am going to declare the functional component child component one. And also just I am going to create an arrow function here. Inside this I am going to return a div, okay, and here I am going to add the array child component one, and here export default child component one. Okay, now what I am going to do here, I am going to add that child component one from child component one. Now if I try to use that component, let's say child component one here, and remove this test here. Now if I try to see refresh, I can see my child component one here. Okay, here also we can put some spaces. Now what I am going to do here, I am going to create child component second two dot js, clear. Now I am going to import react from, also we can use snippets if your VS Code is enabled with the snippets. Just I am typing for my explanations. Okay, we can just copy this one. Okay, child component two, clear. Here I am going to export that one. I had to remove this constant from here. Now what I am going to do here, just import that child component 2, import child component 2 from child component 2. Now what I am going to do here, I am just adding that one. Also we can add some background color to this one, so we can easily identify which child component is. So just I am adding a background color style, flex equal to 1, let's say background color. Red. Okay, so we can also add the background color to the child component also, second child component. We can have a child component here and then here. Okay, we can say it is green. Okay, now if I try to refresh, I can see my child components here. So this should be 2, right? Yes, 2. Now what I am going to do here, I am going to declare a function state here, const counter set counter and use state. Okay, so it should be imported from React. We can just remove the unwanted import and we can just remove this one. Okay, now here what I am going to do, I am going to pass initial value 0. Now what I am going to do, I am going to print the counter value here, and also I can add a div here so that this rest of the things will come in the next line. Yes, now if I try to refresh, I can see my counter here, child component 1 and child component 2. Now what I am going to do here, I am going to declare one button. Okay, button on the on click. What I am going to do, I am going to increment the value, set counter. It should be counter plus 1. Now if I try to refresh, yes, I should add some label increment. Okay, now if I try to refresh, I can see my button and counter value and my two child component. Okay, now if I try to increment the value, yes, this is rendering. Now if I try to inspect it, let's say can introduce the size, and I have increment here. Also, we can just remove this one, and also we can have the console here. Okay, fine, clear. Now, what I am going to do, I am going to add a console here. Okay, inside this console here, console.log child component 1. Clear. Here, I am going to pass one more console child component 2. Clear. Now, if I try to refresh, I can see my two functions are rendering. Whenever this button value, whenever the state in the parent change, this child component also re-rendering, right? So we have to avoid that re-rendering. For that one, what I am going to do, I am going to use memo inside two function. So memo, I am going to wrap my component inside memo. Also the second component also, what I am going to do here also, I am going to pass memo, clear? Also what I have to do here, yes. Memo. Now if I try to refresh, I can see my child component 1 and 2 is rendered. Now if I try to increment the value, this child component are not re-rendering. Clear? Now what I am going to do inside this app.js, I am going to declare one function, const print console. Okay, print console. This is an arrow function. Okay, so inside this one, and what I am going to do, I am going to print my counter value, not counter value, we can just add a console here, print console. Okay, now I am going to pass that function into first component. Okay, print console, I am going to pass this as a props. So inside this component it will be available, so I am going to access this print console using object destruction. And here what I am going to do, here I am going to add one button, clear, on the on click. On the on click, I'm just referring that function. Okay, print console. Now if I try to refresh, when okay, we have to add one div and label, sorry, div here. Okay, now here we can add print console. Okay, now if I try to refresh, I can see my print console button in the child component first. Whenever there is an increment, again child component 1 is re-rendering, right? So we have already used the memo function to avoid the re-rendering using counter, right? Whenever there is a state change, this old parent will re-render, right? So to avoid this re-rendering, we have already used the memo function to avoid the re-rendering, right? But still this is re-rendering child component 1. Whenever there is a state change, in the parent component, the child component 1 is re-rendering, because we have passed one function here, right? So to avoid that one, we have already know about use callback. So I am introduced the use callback also. We can import this use callback from React. Okay, so I have already mentioned use callback syntax. There should be function first, then the dependency. So here we don't have any dependency. I am going to add an array. Okay, so an empty array I have passed. Now if I try to refresh, I can see whenever there is an increment in the parent component, child component is not re-rendering anymore. And also when I try to execute this one, print console is executing, this function is calling perfectly. So we have used the use callback using empty array dependency. Now what I am going to do, I am going to declare one more function here. Okay, const increment counter. Okay, const increment counter. Also what this function will do, so it will increment the value of counter. Okay, so counter plus 1. So we are going to call this function directly here. Okay, so I am going to pass this increment function, increment counter function, to the second child. Okay, second child I am going to pass this one. Okay, now inside this second child, I have to use that function. So I am going to declare one button here also, and just using that function object destruction to access that function. Here I am going to add one button. Okay, increment counter, let's say counter will be Yes, we can use increment. And the on click, I am going to use increment counter. Okay. Now, if I try to refresh, my child component is rendered and second child component also re-rendered. Okay. We can add this as increment counter. Yes, if I try to refresh, I can see my child component is rendering one time, my child component is rendering and child component rendering. Okay. Now, if I try to increment the value, so the again the problem is coming for child component 2, because every time whenever there is a state change, this increment counter function is again and again calling and it is reinitializing. So that's why child component 2 is re-rendering again and again, because this is an unwanted re-rendering, right? Whenever there is a state change in the parent component, okay, whenever there is a state change in the parent component, the child component is rendering unwantedly. See, you can see the child component 2 is rendering. Okay, so what you have to do, we have to use callback for this function also, right? So I am going to declare use callback for this function also. I am going to wrap the use callback inside that function. Okay. Now we have already passed an empty array previously. We can pass empty array as a dependency. Now just wrapped that function in use callback. Now if I try to refresh, I can see child component 1 and 2 is rendering, right? Now what I am going to do, if I try to increment the value, the value is incrementing, right? Value is incrementing. Now if I try to increment using child button, see, the value is no more incrementing, because when there is a declaration this function, this counter value is stored as 1. Now after incrementing, this is not again reinitializing. So what is the problem? We have not passed any dependency. We have a dependency counter value. So we have not passed that counter value here. So that's why ReactJS is also giving an error. React or use callback as a missing dependency. See, missing dependency, because the counter value we are using inside child component, or we are using inside this function. So if we use callback here, so it will reinitialize first time, then it will not initialize when there is a change in the counter value. So for that one, what we have to do, we have to pass the counter as a dependency in the use callback. Okay. Now if I try to refresh, I can see incremented child component is incremented because this is passed. Now if I try to increment it, see, it is working perfectly, because when there is a state change, this increment counter is again reinitialized because we have passed the dependency. So if there is a no dependency, we can pass empty array. Now if there is a dependency inside this callback, you should pass that dependency. Now if you check in the console, you can see that warning is also removed. So we have studied two type of use callback. One is empty callback, you can pass an empty array. Then again, second thing is you can pass a dependency, which values depend on the inside function. Okay, clear? So we can jump into the next lecture.